Could you please first start introducing who you are and what you do?
My name is Cora Pagheel. And I'm a teacher in Tai Chi Chuan and Qigong. And that's it.
That's it. That's actually a pretty funny brief introduction. I know Cora Vergeel already a long time, as a very modest person and very kind to everybody. You give Tai Chi Chuan, among other people, to Alzheimer patients, right?
That's right.
Can you tell me about that first?
Yes, I give lessons in the centra for all the peoples. And I try to give them some tools, how they can move. For me it's important that I can give them some tools, because then they start to think and to feel.
Yeah.
So that's my their own body.
Okay.
Yeah.
How much experience did you have with Alzheimer before you started doing this work for these people?
I think a lot of years.
And
it's not only Alzheimer, but also all the people.
Okay. Yeah. So you basically teach people who are aging, and of whom a subset has Alzheimer.
When you have Alzheimer and you can live in how do you call that?
Older people home.
Then it's a lower level because when you get Alzheimer, you go on to another
department.
Department.
So these are mostly people with beginning Alzheimer.
Well, they are old, and they everybody has something to learn, and I try to activate them to feel their body, and also to remember her own wisdom and what I did in all those years before.
Yeah,
and
retrieve their memories.
Yeah, some memories. Yeah.
Okay.
And they like it because they say, well, I can do it, and so now they are not old, but they can do it.
Did you do a lot of studies, additional studies, to understand the nature of their problems?
I read something, yes, but I'm not a reader. I look, I feel, and I do.
Did you take a lot of notes?
No. Everything is in my brains still.
The most reliable tool of humanity. When you have in your family also Alzheimer, I understand.
Yes, my mother has also Alzheimer, and she's 88, and it's so a half year ago they she got the birds from. Well, you have Alzheimer.
And that's actually pretty recent. That's pretty recent.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. And
did anybody see it coming?
Yes, of course, but the thing that your mother goes still older and older.
Yeah.
And so for me, it was normal.
Yeah. So it's a hidden progression, because you consider it as a normal part of aging.
Yeah.
You think people need more education, that they can see these kind of signs coming on a more large distance of time scale before they develop problems? That
perhaps
people can see early warning signs?
Perhaps it's important, but there is no still no medicine for Alzheimer. So, but if there is a medicine, then you can say, well, we can make a line.
Yeah.
And
we talk about regular medicine, right? Western medicine.
Yeah, okay. The medicine. Yeah.
You think your Tai Chi Chuan can contribute to a solution for Alzheimer?
It helps to feel yourself.
Okay.
And your breathing. You're standing on the floor.
Yeah.
Like that. And accept it, of course, that you have something.
Could you say that people normalize when they practice Tai Chi Chuan like the way how you do it?
That they can normalize it?
No, that they can normalize themselves. Because when you are having Alzheimer, you have, of course, an extreme development.
Yeah.
And normalized means like when they were like 25.
Yeah. Well, you ask what I'm doing about that.
No. we talk about maybe the possibility that Tai Chi Chuan or Qigong can contribute to normalization of their lives, that means that undoing, helping to undo the effects of Alzheimer's.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Because
we're going to investigate this in this in this series.
I do several exercises for myself, and of course I walk in the.
Yeah. Let's talk about you then for a moment, because now you're going to progress a little bit on the other part, because you also have been found to have Alzheimer's.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a bit about it?
Yeah. I'm still, 2 years ago, I had an experience, and I'm standing in the white light.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, they couldn't find anything, but why it's happened.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, what was real.
Mm-hmm.
And several times I've been to the doctor.
Mm-hmm.
So I find, I feel something, it's not okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? I have something, but I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
Well, now, a few times, and after a few times, the doctor sent me to first helpline.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And for me, was it very good. I learned from her. it helps me,
mm-hmm.
but it's not. I have not the ticket from here that I have Alzheimer.
Right. The first diagnose something else, right?
Yeah. They think, you have to look another way. How you live, or what you can do about this and this. Yeah, and for me it was important, but after a while I thought, it's still the same.
Yeah, they gave you first medication for thyroid problems.
For?
Thyroid problems.
Yeah.
Okay, why did they think it's a thyroid problem?
I don't know.
Okay.
They tested.
Okay.
Yeah, it was in the hospital, they tested that.
There's something wrong anyway with your thyroid.
Yeah.
All right. And we're going to go through all the different things through which they came up with the idea that maybe it's Alzheimer. You told me earlier that before in your life you sometimes had visions.
Yeah.
Because you try to follow sort of a spiritual life.
Well, I follow the line of the Tai Chi Chuan and Qigong.
Okay, but that is very wide, so
yeah.
Can you be a little bit more specific?
Yeah. I follow my teacher.
And who was? It was?
Sifu Kominho.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Amstelveen.
Yeah.
And from him I get all the knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
After that, it was possible that I could teach you Tai Chi Chuan after 10 years.
Yeah, yeah.
So I practiced 10 years by Amin Ho.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. The next thing is that, does he teach also that having visions is normal in Touch Chan?
No, he's very clear.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Practical.
Yeah.
Okay, and from where did you develop this tendency to have visions? Good question, huh?
Good question.
Yeah.
I can say from myself, but I follow a course from 2 years.
Yeah.
For chakra therapist.
Ah, chakra therapist.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you develop it. Yeah. Ontwikkeld. Your own feeling inside,
yeah.
Outside.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Yeah.
How do you see the difference between the visions that you had and the hallucination that you experienced?
The difference?
Yeah.
What's real and what's not real.
Okay.
Yeah. So, it's also what you feel is you think that you feel it, but it's something else.
Right.
Yeah. And what you see could also be something else.
Right.
So I'm very nuchter.
Yeah. Sober. Mentally sober.
Yeah. So I see it or not.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
And when you had this hallucination, this was. How did you experience that?
From 2 years ago?
Yeah.
Yeah. For me was, I was in shock.
Yeah.
Because I thought I go to the white light.
Right. So it's like how people describe death sensation.
Yeah, I think so.
Right.
I think so. That's what.
You had 2 more hallucinations later.
After that, yeah.
How were they?
That was, how do you call it? Angstigend?
Frightening, yeah.
Yeah. Frightening. And because before I drive in a car,
yeah,
and it was slow. We drive slowly,
yeah, in a traffic jam.
Hmm?
In a traffic jam.
And the car before me, he comes to me,
yeah,
instead of I come to him,
yeah.
So I thought, this is not real.
Yeah. Okay.
I thought, the same time, this is not real.
Mm-hmm. So you saw the front side of a car coming.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and the other time, what did you see?
Another time I lay on a
bench.
Bench, yeah. And
public space.
Yeah, public space, yeah. And I thought, I see everybody lying to the. And I thought, I do that also. Mm. And I lay down, and I look, I put my, I do my eyes open, and in a split second, the sky come to me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that were 2 things, and then I went to the doctor.
Okay. When did they find out, when and how did they diagnose that you have Alzheimer's?
It takes a long time.
Mm-hmm. Did they do tests on you, or did they just?
No. First of all, I was by the first line.
Yeah, first line healthcare.
Yeah. And it was very good. I like to talk with her.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a very good ideas mm-hmm. for me. I'm always open when when somebody else says something
mm-hmm.
to me. And then I say, yeah, I can look to that and that. But after a while, I thought, it's still the same.
Yeah.
And after that, I come to the doctor. And he said, I did it. And now, it's still the same.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how did they come to the conclusion that then you have Alzheimer's?
I went to the VU,
Yeah.
UMC.
Yeah. Free University. Yeah. Medical Hospital. Yeah.
And I was there for one day, and I could also onderzoeken.
Yeah, blood test.
And everything. Yeah.
Scanning. Brain scan.
Yeah. And after one day, I come by the professor, and he said, "Well, no, this is you have Alzheimer." Yeah.
Okay, that's very clear.
Yeah.
The hallucination effect, according to all the medical information about Alzheimer, says this is a late stage. Did they also explain to you about this is a late stage?
No.
Okay.
No. Well, I'm talking to you, so when I'm in another stage,
No, that's why, because the hallucination usually come in an end stage where people really start losing their connection with reality.
Yeah.
That's where the hallucinations come in. And that's also why I had a question, like, how do you see the difference between vision and hallucination? Because what if what you have experienced actually is the vision and the other ones are maybe fantasy? What if that happens? I just make up some suggestions.
I don't know what's real or not real, you see? Because my eyes see it.
Yeah. If you look at stories from the Buddha in Asia, or you see some Christian stories, when you talk about visions, it's like as intense as what you talk about, what you call a hallucination. So that's why I asked that. I don't want to say like it was not a hallucination, because the difference between hallucination and visions is very difficult to discern. And but the main ingredient of your hallucination is that you were frightened, right?
Right.
When you were afraid, when you had the experience, you had fear.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
What's this?
Surprise! Yeah.
Surprise.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. Well, because for diagnosis from Chinese medicine perspective, that would mean fear scatters the qi, right? Yeah. So it means it disorganizes you. And it takes a long time to reorganize. And there's a lot of diseases who have a scattering of qi as an origin.
Mm-hmm.
And in aging, qi gradually decays,
mm-hmm.
right? Because it is not as concentrated and focused anymore because of the kidneys and so on.
Mm-hmm.
And so in the coming episodes that we're going to make together, recordings, we are going to also do some diagnostics. And we go talk about all the different kind of signs and symptoms that you experience, but also what you recognized in what your students in the care home experienced. So we can compare these things and what you also experienced from your mom.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Yeah.
So we can go through all these different kind of things.
Yeah.
And I will complement what we talk about in the articles that go together with the films, with more medical information for students.
That's nice.
You can work on it and we can start build a knowledge base and see how things work for you.
Yeah.